Good evening. There are serious cracks in the state government tonight after the National Party took a major step towards ending its coalition with the Liberals. The Deputy Premier says his MPs will abstain from supporting government legislation or bills until changes are made to koala habitat protection laws.
It's the tree change that's led John Barilaro to finally cross a line he's threatened many times before.
We are not the coalition today. We are the National Party.
His 19 national MPs in state parliament will no longer attend joint party room or leadership meetings with the Liberals, and they will abstain from voting on government bills, a move that raises serious questions about whether Gladys Berejiklian still commands the numbers required to govern.
And what is the status of her government this afternoon? Because it is my belief that that government is no longer functioning.
Confusion amplified by conflicting messages. First, it appeared the Nats were heading to Parliament's crossbench.
What I've announced today is that effectively it's put all members on the crossbench in a roundabout way.
But then...
But we're not on the crossbench. We are still in government. We are the Nationals.
Are you still Deputy Premier?
Well, I'm not on the crossbench.
Despite planning to stall their own government's business, Nationals want to remain ministers and still attend cabinet meetings.
I don't understand how you can walk into cabinet, be bound by cabinet solidarity, and then walk into the parliament and do a completely different thing.
And this is what is tearing the coalition apart. Koalas. More specifically, planning regulation to protect koala habitat that has been in effect since March. The Nationals claim they only approved it late last year on the condition their concerns about farmers' land rights would be addressed.
In the end, it felt like our concerns were not heard.
Planning Minister Rob Stokes maintains the policy is aimed at preventing habitat being cleared for new subdivisions on the north coast.
And the idea that somehow that this is an attack on farmers is just patently untrue.
So then why are they doing this?
Well, you'd have to ask them.
On camera, senior Liberals say a tension with the National Party can be healthy for the coalition. But the fact John Barilaro didn't call the Premier before holding his press conference this morning suggests there may be a bigger issue than many want to publicly admit.
The Premier has summoned her deputy to a meeting to please explain.
Lachlan Kennedy joins me now from State Parliament. Lachlan, we have just heard from the Premier.
Well, that meeting has finished, Sandra, and Gladys Berejiklian has come out swinging in an extraordinary statement. She has told John Barilaro his concerns will be addressed at an upcoming cabinet meeting, but if that is not good enough for him and his colleagues and they want to remain on the crossbench, well, they cannot stay in cabinet. She has made it clear they cannot be in cabinet and on crossbench at the same time, and they have until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning to decide what they want to do. The Premier says she will not hesitate, if required, to go to Government House tomorrow morning and to swear in a new ministry. So, Sandra, an extraordinary development from the Premier today, not backing down. I am told the Liberal Party is 100% united behind them. Obviously, John Barilaro with some big threats this morning. Well, tonight, for the National Party, it is decision time. Sandra?
Indeed. Breaking news there. Lachlan Kennedy, thank you.